this video I'm going to show you how to use typography for Photoshop Action. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to use this photo here as an example for demonstration of the action. So I'm going to create from this photo this effect. Okay, so as you can see, what the action does, it will disperse the parts of your photo that you have brushed into the letters, and you can choose you're choosing the direction of the dispersion, and you can choose from 5 different directions: right, left, up, down, in the middle. And you're also choosing the letters size. You can choose from 3 different sizes for each direction. You can choose from small, medium, and large sizes. Okay, so the action also creates 10 color looks, 10 different color looks that you can choose from, and there are a lot of options for customizing the results. So then I'm going to customize this effect and create this effect here. Okay, so as you can see, what you can do is you can turn your subject into the typography effect. Okay, and this text here is a fully editable, so you can use your own text, you can change the font, line height, and so on. Okay, you can also change the background color. So let me just show you a few more examples that I have made using this action. Okay, so from this photo I created this. Okay, that's it. So let's just get back to our photo. So I'm just gonna close these 2 windows. So there, when you open up your photo, before you use the action, there are a few things that you should check to make sure the action will run without any error. Okay, so the first thing that you should check is that your photo is a background layer. So it should be called the background and have this little lock icon. So if you have something like this or anything else, just go to layer, new, and just choose a background from layer. Okay. And then just click on this little arrow here and go to the panel options and make sure you got this option checked. Add copy to copy layers and groups, okay? And then go to the image mode and make sure your photo is in RGB color mode, 8-bit canon. And check the image size. So your image size should be, your photo should be at least about 1500 pixels wide or high, okay? And resolution should be 300. So this photo is too big, and if you're using 2 large photos like this, the letters may appear too small. Okay, so the best is to use the photos that are, let's say, from 1500 to about 1400 pixels wide or high. Okay, so I'm just gonna lower the size. Just gonna change the size slightly like this. Just click OK. And if your photo is in resolution is 72, let me just show you what that. So for example, your photo is 72 here, okay, like this. And all you have to do is to just type the 300 there, and then just decrease the size here, okay. And that's it. You will have the 300 resolution photo. So just turn off this. And to load the action, just go to Window, Actions, and click on the little arrow here, Load Actions, and just choose the action that can be downloaded. Okay, the action will appear in your Actions panel, and as you can see, you got 5 directions for each of these 3 different sizes, for small, medium, and large letters. Okay, and these 2 actions are just the blank actions. They serve as the dividers, and they have made this panel much more visually readable and easier to cope. Okay, so to load the brushes, you can just pick a brush tool, click anywhere, right click inside the canvas, click on this little gear icon, and just choose a load brushes, and just choose the brushes that can be downloaded. Okay, and the brushes will appear over here in your brushes panel. And to load the pattern, just click right click over there and choose the pattern stamp tool, click on this little arrow here, now click on this little gear icon again, and just choose load patterns, and just choose the pattern that can be downloaded, okay? And it will appear in your patterns panel. Okay, so all you have to do now is to just go to the layer, new layer, and so you're going to create a new layer, but it's very important to name it brush, and all letters must be lowercase. You must type the brush exactly the same as this, otherwise the action won't work. So just click OK, and all you have to do now is to fill in your subject with a color. So you can do that on a lot of ways. For example, you can just pick a brush tool and choose any color, colors that matter, and just brush like this. And what I'm going to do here, which will be in this case much easier than brushing, is to select my original photo layer and just pick the magic pen tool. Okay, just gonna lower the tolerance a little bit like this, and just gonna select the background. So just hold the shift button to add more areas into the selection, just like that. Okay, let me just zoom in a little bit and to check if I have made a proper selection, just gonna click here, just like that. And as you can see here, the selection actually took a part of the subject, so I'm just gonna pick a pen tool and just click here, and then just click here and hold and drag just like this, just to make a path around that selection, and go right click, make selection, and choose subtract from selection, so to remove that. And just gonna press Control Shift and I, or Command Shift I, to inverse the selection, and then go to select modify smooth, to smooth a little bit the selection, just gonna set 2 pixels radius here, just like that. And then just gonna select my brush layer and hold Shift F5 and just choose a foreground color here, just like that. So that's it, and I can just pick some small brush to correct this. Okay, and what I also want to do here is to add a little bit space on the sides and on the bottom, as I want to use the small letters down action. So I get it will be a down direction. I need more space here for the letters. So to add to change the canvas size, just go to add image canvas size. Just gonna change this to pixels and the relative here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a 400 pixels to the size, just like this. And just going to go to image canvas size again. And I'm going to add at the bottom about 1700 pixels. So just click here when you wish to add the more space at the bottom, and just gonna click OK, just like that. And then I'm just gonna select my original photo layer, and just gonna make a selection around this white area using the rectangular marquee tool, just like this. And then press Shift F5 and choose quantity over here. Just click OK. It needs a little bit of time to fill it, just like that. And then I'm just gonna create the selection on the other side, but without including the subject, and just press Shift F5 again. Just like that. And I'm just gonna make the same selection over here, Shift F5. So we are actually filling these white blank areas with a bit of background of our photo, like just like that. You'll see that here we gotta duplicate our subject parts. So just gonna right click here, choose a patch tool, just make some selection around these parts that you want to remove, and then just click and drag to the background, to the part of your background that looks similar to this one here in the background, just like that. And just gonna do the same here. Just like that. Press Ctrl D to deselect. And all you have to do now is to play the action. So The action will stop a few times with the messages asking you to check some settings or to do some quick things. Okay, so I'm going to just gonna play the action now, and then later I'm going to fasten the video, and I'll get back to it when the each message shows. Okay, so the one message will show on the beginning, so just gonna click play. Okay, here's the first message, and it says in next pop-up window choose PSD file name, text small that can be downloaded, and click open. Choose continue to proceed. So just click continue, and you should choose text small letter because I use the small letters size of the action here. But of course, if you want, you can use you can open a larger or medium. Okay, if you wish that your subject typography letters are larger than the dispersed letters. Okay, so just gonna choose this one. Click open, and here we got another message, and it says, now using the move tool, click anywhere inside the canvas and just hold and drag the text layer into your photo document and make sure that the text covers your subject. After that, play the action again to stop to proceed. So you just click stop, and using the move tool, just click on the text and just hold and drag it over here, and it's important only to cover your subject here. Okay, and all you have to do now is to play the action. So I'm going to fasten the video here and get back when the next message shows. Okay. Okay, so here we got the next message, and it says now brush over the area that you want to disperse. After that, play the action again. Notice proper brush will be already selected by the action. You may change size of the brush according to your needs. Choose stop to proceed. So just click stop and just zoom in a little bit. I'm just gonna change the color here. That's that, and all you have to do now is to brush over the areas that you wish to disperse. Okay. And also, you see that this layer has a layer mask here. So, for example, you wish to brush over his arm here, and you don't have to be careful. Are you going to brush outside of your subject because this layer mask is preventing that? So you can just brush like this, and as you can see, it will only brush over your subject. It will not brush outside of the subject. So just gonna brush like that, and I'm just gonna brush over here. And a little bit over here. Just like that. And I'm gonna brush a little bit over here. Okay, and I'm going to fasten the play the action and fasten the video again and get back when the next message shows. Okay, so here we got the next message, and it says a next pop-up window, make sure that scripted pattern is checked and random fill is selected script. Choose continue to proceed. Just choose continue. And so you all you have to do is to just check these scripted patterns option. Okay, these options will already settled properly. Here you don't have to change the pattern because the action will not use this pattern. It will be used the one that's recorded in the command. Okay, so this doesn't matter. So just don't change any settings over here, and just check the scripted patterns and choose the random fill. And after you click OK, the action will continue to work. So I'm fastening the video here again. Okay. Okay, so here we got another message, and it says in next pop-up window, save your file as a PSD file. You can use any file name and save location. And you get a notice, you will have to choose a file later. So choose continue to proceed. Just click continue. And I'm just gonna name it example. And what's important here that you got a format Photoshop, okay? So that it saves your photo in a PSD format. And you can save it anywhere you like. I'm just gonna save it on my desktop because later during the action will ask you to choose the file that you have previously saved. Okay, and after you click save, the action will continue to work. So I'm going to fasten the video here again and get back when the next message shows. So just click OK. Okay, so here we got another message, and here it says in next pop-up window, make sure you have the following settings: horizontal scale 5, vertical scale 5, displacement map stretch to fit, and underdefined areas. Undefined areas to repeat edge pixels. Then click OK, choose the PSD file you have saved before, and click Open. Choose Continue to proceed. So just click Continue. Make sure you got the proper settings, and just gonna change this to 5 and 5, and click OK. And here, all you have to do is to select the PSD file you have previously saved, and just click Open. Then the actually continue to work, and you will after just a few seconds get another message. So I'm not going to fasten the video here, so just click open. Okay, so another message, it says now select each layer that is marked with the red color and press Control or Command plus F on your keyboard. You must select each layer separately. Choose stop to proceed. Just choose stop. And what actually Control F, Command F, Command does, it repeats the last filter. And the reason why you have to do that manually is because if it's made the action do it, then the action would have to ask you each time to confirm the settings and to choose the file. So this will be actually much easier and faster way. Okay, so just select you got to select all these files with the red color. So just select the file, the layer, and just press Control F or Command F, just like this. And you have, as it says, the message to select each layer separately. Okay, so you can just do it like this. And it's pretty much quick. Okay, that's it. And all you have to do then is to just play the action again. So, and I'm going to fasten the video here. Okay, so here we got another message, and this is the last message, and it says in next pop-up window adjust the blur center according to your subject position and dispersion direction you have chosen. Choose continue to proceed. So just click continue, and you should leave all these settings as the actions have set them. And all you have to do is to adjust this blur center. So just gonna. And as I have chosen the down direction, so I'm just gonna set it from the, it goes from the top toward the bottom, and I'm just gonna set it on the middle. Okay, so when you click OK, they actually continue to work, and as I said, this is the last message, pop-up message that you got. So I'm going to fasten the video here and get back to when the action is finished. So then I'm going to show you how to customize the results that you got. Okay, so the action here has just finished, and first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to close the actions panel. Okay, and the first thing that you probably want to do is to just quickly close down all these folders. And how to quickly do that is to just, while this group is selected, it will be automatically selected by the action. You just hold Control and Alt buttons for PC or Command Option for a Mac, and just click on the little arrow here, so that way we'll close down all the folders. And let's see what we got here. So this is a brush layer that I have made on the beginning of the video. And if you wish to play the action again using the same photo, the same brushed area, but you wish to change the direction or the letter size, you can just delete this group and play the action again without need to brush over your subject again. Okay. Or if you wish to just play the action again using the same direction, same brushed area, because the action is made so every time you run the action, even if you use the same brushed area, you'll get unique results. So action will always create a differently deployed these letters and with a slightly different form and so on. Okay. So let's just open the folder. So what we got here are the adjustments. So we're just gonna open the folder, and the first layer here we got is the overall sharpening. So what the layer does, it adds a sharpening to the whole photo. And how you change the sharpening is you just click on this word opacity here and just drag it aside, just like this. Okay, so I'm just going to set something like this, and this is the overall vibrance. So when you double click here, you can adjust the vibrance of your photo and saturation. Okay, so I'm going to make these settings. And this is the overall brightness. So all you have to do is to just move these three pointers to change the brightness. Okay. And I'm just gonna use by default. I'm not going to change the brightness. And this is the overall contrast. So You change the contrast, so you just click on the word opacity and just drag it aside, just like that, okay? So just gonna add a little bit of contrast, something like this. And that is the photo tint, so you can change the density here, you can change the filter, okay? Just like that. So just gonna use this one. And I'm gonna lower its opacity, something like this, the density, okay? And what we got here are the color looks. So the color look one is the turned on by the action. So if you wish to try with another, you can simply turn it off and turn on some others, see how it looks. If you don't like it, try with another. You can also combine a few of color looks. For example, just turn on this one, lower its opacity, then turn on this one as well, and just play with the opacities, okay? And I'm going to use this time this default one, okay? The selected by action, the color look one. So what we got here it says group empties. So these are actually this group, all these layers are simulating the holes in your subject that are made by dispersing the letters from those areas, okay? And there are layers you can, if you wish, you can turn more, remove the empties if you like, but these lines we got here are because the sharpening layer, so just gonna turn it off for now, okay? So you can turn off some of these layers, for example, if you wish to have less empties, and these empties are made by filling some of the letters here inside your brushed area with some color, some of the background colors, okay, to simulate that effect. And it may happen about very rarely that color doesn't is not suited well, or for example, if you've chosen the down direction, but you don't have too much canvas size here, you don't have much space here, and then you got cut it off these empties. So you can always make them manually. All you have to do is just select this layer, make a new layer, or you just, for example, wish to add more empties. So just pick a brush tool and just pick some of these three layers, these three brushes here, sorry, and I'm just gonna lower the size to about 300. And all you have to do is to, you can just make a hold control or a command for Mac, just click on the layer brush and just add this layer mask here to make sure you don't brush with the outside of your subject. And then just select this layer here and just brush like this, okay? Just like that. And what you can do then, if you use the white letters here, you can just double click here, choose the color overlay, and just pick some color from the background, okay, just like this, to make more realistic result. And you can just right click on this layer mask and apply the layer mask. You can rasterize the layer style as well. And maybe you can even go to filter, distort, displace, and then just select the PSD that you have saved to make it look more realistic, just like that. Okay? And you can remove the empties by brushing. For example, if you wish to remove only some empties, you can just brush black, set for gal color to black, and just brush over the empties while this mask is selected here. Okay? So let's see what I got here. These are the letters, and they are fully layered. Okay? So you see here we got a large blurred letters and we got a small blurred letters, and they're all layered. And well, what you can do, you can select any of these letters, you can just take a move tool, you can just move them, okay, just like that. You can pick a last tool and just go right click, free transform, and you can rotate them, you can scale letters, okay, you can add them, you can blur some of them by adding a Gaussian blur, okay. And if you wish to remove some letters, you can simply hide the layers, okay. Or for example, some of the letters are going over some important part of your subject, you can just select this layer mask and set from ground color to black and simply brush over the letters that you wish to remove, just like this, okay. And if you wish to create more letters, you can do just that just in a few seconds. You can, for example, select this layer and hold the shift button, click on this one here, and just go right click, duplicate layers, okay, just like that, and press control or command E to merge them into one layer, but you don't have to leave them layered as well. And then just using the move tool, just gonna move them like this. So you're going to create more letters. Okay, and we like to merge these layers is because sometimes, for example, I wish to add more letters here, but I don't want to add them over here as well. So then what you can do is just add a layer mask and just brush with the black color where you don't want to add the letters. Okay, just like this, for example. Okay, so just gonna close this group. And what we got here is the letters motion. So we got two types of the letters motion here. So just turn off this one. Okay, so you got this one. You can just click over opacity to change the opacity, the visibility of these blur of this motion. And I usually use this some low values like this. And this one is a little bit different, as you can see. And also going to use some low, small value like this. Okay. And I'm going to get back to this group later. Before that, I'm going to show you this one layer here. So this is a background blur. And when you just click on the layer here, you got a Gaussian blur here. So you can just double click there, and you can change the blur of the background. And all you have to do is to select this layer mask and pick a brush tool, pick some soft brush, and set foreground color to white, to black, and just brush over the areas where you wish to remove it. Okay, so you can make a nice focus effects with this. Okay, just like that. And you can always press Alt or Option for a Mac and just click on this layer here to see if you have missed some areas there. Okay, so if you wish to add the blur somewhere, you just, and you have previously brushed with the black, just set from ground color to right, just brush like this, and you will add the blur there. Okay. So, and what's very important is that if you have moved some letters, remove them, duplicate and create more letters, something like that, is to just create this layer again. And why is that? Because when I change this, so you see all these edges here, they are giving a sharpen to your photo. And when you, for example, remove some of the letters or add more, these layers will still remain the same, so you will not give a proper sharpening. So all you have to do is to just delete this layer and select the top one here. Just hold Alt Control Shift or and E, or Command Option Shift and E, just to make some snapshot. And then go to Filter Other High Pass and set radius to 2 pixels. Change the blending mode of the layer to the hard light, and then just adjust the opacity to create the sharpen. Okay, that's it. And now I'm going to show you how to create a second type of the effect that you can create using this action that I have shown you at the beginning of the video. And it's just going to turn on the subject typography group. And I'm going to turn off the sharpening again. So when you open this folder, you will see you got a text color, text, and the background color. And you can just double click on this color box here. You can choose any color that you like. Okay, just going to use the black color. It will not be pure black because you got these adjustments here that the color option that will change the color. Okay, so and what you got here is the text. Okay, and this layer here is a text color, so it just gives the color to your subject typography. Okay, and if it appears sometimes that you got like these edges here because it's not perfectly brushed, you just got some these thin lines, what you can do is just select this layer mask and go right click and just choose refine mask. And I usually use some settings about 10 here, it just contrast 100, and let's use about -7 here. Just click OK and it'll fix that. So when you're using the subject typography, you should just turn on this empties layer. And to create the empties here, what you gotta do is select this layer mask, pick a brush tool, set foreground color to black, and just choose some of these layers. And again, I'm going to lower the size to 300 as I have used the small letters here, okay? And all you have to do is to just click and hold, okay? You can just move the brush like this. You'll see that you'll begin to remove the parts. So I'm just gonna brush on the place where I have brushed the disperse, just like that. And you can change the brushes, of course, so you can choose any of these three. And I'm just gonna brush over here as well, and over here. And if you accidentally remove too much of your subject, you can just change this color to white and brush again, and then you will start bringing back those parts that you removed, okay? Just like that. And what I'd like to do is to just pick a soft brush then, and then just hold Alt or Option for Mac, just click this layer mask here. And I just like to remove to just brush over these edges, just like this. On the edges that I have brushed previously, so unbrush of the edges that I have previously brushed with those letters brushed to remove some parts, just like that. Okay, let's just brush a little bit over here as well. And a little bit over here. Just gonna cover these letters that have brushed with the white. Okay, so just gonna brush like this. And a little bit here. Okay, then just click Alt or Option again here. And that's it, okay? You can make some, just brush a little bit more with these letters brush. I'm just gonna brush a little bit over here. And just like that. Okay. So you can get back to the adjustments and make some additional changes. And what's important is that you create this sharpen layer again, okay? And before that, I'm just gonna show you another thing. So when you double click on this smart object, here we got a text that, as you can see, is completely customizable, editable. So you can just paste your own text here, or you can just select the text. You can change the font style, the font size, and you can just go to Window and choose a paragraph here. Select the character. You can change the line height, the letter spacing, and so on. And all you have to do after you make those changes, just press Control or Command S. File, or go to File, Save, and the changes will be automatically applied to your subject here, okay? So I'm just gonna create this layer now again, so just gonna press Alt, Control, Shift, and D, or Command, Option, Shift, E for a Mac, and go to, you probably have the filter here, so just select there, hard light, and then just adjust the sharpen, okay? And you can change, of course, these settings. So I'm just gonna change a little bit of brightness here, something like this. Okay. So I'm pretty much happy with the result. So I hope you understood everything. But if you have any troubles with the action or you got any questions, feel free to contact me anytime via my Envato profile page. Thanks for watching. Bye.